Hello friends, welcome to the tutorial of ADU.NET, and in this video we are going to study how to populate our data set with multiple tables. Now if you are not aware of populating a data set, please watch the video of populating data set first, okay? Then watch this video. Now I already have a database created, which is ADU test DB, okay? And I added that connection in Server Explorer, and you can view here that there are three tables in my database. Okay, if you are not aware of Server Explorer or how to add a connection in a Server Explorer, please watch the video of connection first. Okay, so I already added this connection. There are already some tables available in my database, and now what we are going to do, whenever I click on this populate button, my data set should get populated with content of course and student. We are going to populate these two tables, course and student, in our single data set. Okay, again the result of data set we are not going to show anywhere. I'll just show you how it get populated only, okay? And by the process of debugging I'm going to show you. So let us write the code on populate button. Now let me add required namespaces. So imports system.data, because it is required for data set, and imports system.data.sql client for SQL Server classes. Now let us create a connection object first. So deem CN as new SQL connection. And let us write a connection string, or we'll pass a connection string to our constructor. So I'm copying it from here. So I already explained you how to get that connection string from Server Explorer. Okay. Now what is the next step? Next step is to create a data adapter. We adds new SQL data adapter. Now again here we are going to use a constructor of data adapter, and here we have to pass a select command. Okay, definitely select command is nothing but your select query. So here I'll say select star from course, and here we are going to populate a data from two tables. So you can separate the second query by semicolon and specify it again. So select star from student, and second argument will be object of connection class. Second object will be a object of connection class. Now look at here carefully. If you are using SQL Server, then it is possible that you can specify a multiple query in this way and separated by semicolon, but in other database it is not allowed. So what is the alternative for that? Definitely we are going to study, but first of all we will see this approach. Okay, now next thing, the result of select queries, we are going to put it in a data set. So let us create object of data set first. So deem DS as new data set. Okay, now the next method, next step is to invoke the fill method of a data adapter. So da.fill, pass the argument which is your data set object. Now that's it, we're done with the code. Okay, so what this code will do, it will populate our data set with the result of this two query. Now fill method actually create two tables because we are firing a two select command. Now let me put a breakpoint here. Okay, and let us run this. I'll click over here. So now we will debug this, and now I am pressing F10 key, or you can use this symbol, step over. Okay, now actually this is the most important method. Now let us view the content of data set by clicking on this magnifier symbol. See, your course content get populated. But where are the content of student? Just click over here on this drop down and select the table 1. So these are the content of our student table. So in this way, you can populate a data from multiple tables and store it in a single data set. See, many times many programmer or student make this mistake that they use different data set for different table and different data adapter for different table. Okay, so if it is possible, if you are coding in a single event procedure or under a single event, and if you require the data from multiple tables, it is better to use a single data adapter and single data set. But again, disadvantage of this method, actually it is not disadvantage, but suppose you want to mention a specific name to this table. Now what happened here? Course table name is table here and student table name is table 1 here. So it automatically assigns this name. But suppose you want to assign your explicit name to your table. In that case, we have to use different approach. Okay. If you are passing a query, multiple queries by separating semicolon or in this way, in that case, you cannot specify a table name explicitly while filling your data set. Okay, or the databases that do not support this approach of semicolon. In that case, we have to use different method. So let me comment this part. Okay, now let us see the different approach of filling a data set with multiple tables. So let me collapse this also. So I'll get a big work area. Now let us create a data adapter object as new SQL data adapter. Now we are not going to create a constructor. We are not going to use constructor. Now create an object of select command which belongs to data adapter. See how to instantiate it. DA.select command is equal to new SQL command. This command is nothing but a SQL command only. Now next step is to set the properties of select command of data adapter. So da dot select command dot connection is equal to cn. Okay, so da dot select command dot command text is equal to your select command, that is select star from course. Okay, now if you are not aware of this the command object, please watch the video of command object, and I explain some examples also, so it will be more helpful you to relate with this. Okay, now next step is to fill the data set. Okay, now this data adapter will execute this command, and put a result in a data set. Now here I can specify a name for my table, because currently it is having only a single query. Now after this, suppose I want to populate my data set with another table, what will I do? I'll again create a new select command. The select command is equal to new SQL command. Now da dot select command is equal to dot connection is equal to cn. Now da dot select command dot command text is equal to your second query. So select star from student. Now again give call to the fill method of data adapter, pass the data set object and specify the table name. Again, it is not mandatory to specify a table name. If you do not specify the table name, then what happens? This will be table and this will be table 1. Okay, now let us execute this. Okay, so I'll click over here. So we already put a debug point. Let us step over here, or you can press F10 key, or you can use this symbol. Now let us check the content of data set. See, now it has a course table and just a single table. Okay, and look at the name. Now it is not table, it is course, because this name we specified here. Now let us debug again. Now let us check the content of data set. See, course and student. Okay, so whenever your database do not support a queries separated by semicolon, as we saw in the previous approach, like this, okay, in that case you can use this way. Okay, I hope you understand this, how to populate a data set with multiple tables from your database. Thank you.